بس كام؟ The objectives of this lab. First, you have to identify the layers of the skin. Then to differentiate between thick and thin skin. And to identify the layers of the epidermis and dermis. يلا ايش في عندك؟ احكي مع التليفون مع اصحابك خليهم يجيبوا لك واحد استناه وتعال مستناك مسكرش يلا بسرعه بسرعه and then to identify the appendages اللي هم like the hair and the sebaceous gland and sweat glands okay The skin is composed of two layers. Firstly, in contact with the surface, we have the epidermal layer, which is a layer of epithelium, اللي هو keratinized, stratified, squamous epithelium. شايفين this dark layer? هاي هي the epidermis layer. Okay? Then, under the epidermis, we have the dermis, which is a connective tissue layer. I have a hair follicle here. I can identify a hair follicle here. And some sebaceous glands like these. When you see a sebaceous gland or a hair follicle, it is surely thin skin. Okay? And also, when you see that the epidermis has a relatively low thickness, it is a thin layer of epidermis. This type of tissue is thin skin. Okay? Sebaceous gland, hair follicle, and relative thickness of the epidermis is low. Okay? طب كمان نشوف هون under these layers اللي هم بيكونوا skin under the skin we have the hypodermis layer اللي هي not a part of the skin. It acts to attach the skin with the lower tissues. Okay? In comparison with the previous slide, here we have relatively thick layer of epidermis, اللي حكينا هو stratified keratinized squamous epithelium. I cannot identify any hair follicle or sebaceous gland. So this type of tissue is thick skin. The layers of the epidermis at the bottom near the base or in contact with the basal membrane I have the basal layer which is cuboidal to columnar cells or مسميهم polygonal cells these are basophilic cells they are has high mitotic activity cells here have high mitotic activity But this layer is the stratum basally or basal layer. Above this layer, and it is the germinative layer. The new cells from this layer go up and renew the cell. Okay? Above this layer, we have the stratum spinosum. Spinosum is referred to the shape of the cells that they have spinous processes. To make desmosomes between the cells, to make tight attachment between the cells. So this layer is the stratum spinosum. Above this layer, we have this dark basophilic layer of flattened cell. And then as we are going from the bottom to the surface, the cells start to be more flattened. Okay? In this layer, which is basophilic, dark layer, We have a granules inside the cell. هلا رح نشوفهم in another slide. But these cells or this layer is the stratum granulosum. Okay? Then we have a translucent xenophilic layer of dead cells, dead I cannot identify any nucleus inside the cell. A nucleated layer, dead layer. Okay, just a cell membrane and keratin fibers embedded in this cell membrane inside it. Okay? This layer only can be identified in the case of thick skin. في حالة thin skin, you cannot identify the stratum lucidum. ماشي؟ As we are going up, keratin fibers, the molecular weight of the keratin fibers increases. So in the stratum corneum, the same. They are dead cells, just a thickened cell membrane. Inside it, we have a thick or condensed keratin fibers. وهي the last layer, or the first layer in contact with the surface. Okay? Stratum corneum. Okay? بس بالcondensation of the keratin fibers. Not condensed. Okay? التنتين dead cells. التنتين خلاص فيهم مش يعني. Okay? Now, to identify the layers of the dermis. The layers of the dermis, we have two layers. The first one beneath the epidermis. كم واحد جهازه طلع عن السيستم؟ طب إذا اللي جنبك شغال روح معي اللي جنبك. راح نحل المشكلة على السريع. بس اثنين جنب بعض يكون 10. هسه اللي أنا علي. طيب هسه هيك داخلين؟ طيب خلص. يلا مكانك خلص. مكانك اللي دخلت يلا. طيب the layers of the dermis we have two layers, the one under the epidermal layer in contact with the basal membrane راح تكون the papillary dermis وهي thin layer. Okay, thin layer, loose connective tissue. Loose, that means no more cells and less fibers. يعني نشوف الخلايا أكثر. أوكي تنزل هون deeper to this area can identify the reticular dermis which is composed of yes اللي هو dense irregular connective tissue. We have more fibers and less cells. ماشي نرجع على البابيلاري dermis. منين إجا اسمها بابيلاري؟ Here we have a projections of the dermis inside the dermis, of the dermis inside the epidermis. شايفينها؟ هذول الريجنز. This region here, a projection of dermis inside the epidermis. We call it dermal papillae. عشان هيك اسمها this layer papillary dermis. Okay? The other side, I have invaginations of epidermis inside the dermis. Okay? And these are the epidermal ridges. Then we have interdigitation between the epidermis and dermis, the epidermal ridges and the dermal papillae. Okay? عشان نزيد الاتاتشمنت بيناتهم ما ينفصلوا. Here, again the layers of the epidermis, stratum basally. طبعا all the cells in the skin, we call them keratinocytes except Langerhans cell, Merkel's and melanocytes. والباقي كلهم شو اسمهم؟ Keratinocytes. Okay, طبعا هم الماجوريتي. هلا هون this is the basal layer. attached to the basal membrane, basement membrane. Then I have the spinosa. Then, تذكروا الجرانيولز اللي حكينا عنها والجرانيولز. Here appear clearly the granules inside the cell, basophilic, phosphorylated granules, اللي هم كيراتينوهالاي granules. Why we need these granules? To increase the molecular weight of the keratin fibers to become more condensed, okay, as we are going up. ماشي؟ طبعا in this field I cannot identify the stratum lucidum. So this type of tissue is thin skin. منشوف هون الديرمال بابل اللي شايفينها والإبيديرمال ريجز. طيب here between the basal keratinocytes I have a lighter cell على البوينتر. Yes, this cell is a melanocyte. إذا lighter cell between the basal keratinocytes is melanocyte. طيب هي it is lighter while it is synthesized melanin because yes it do not store the melanin, it's just synthesized and transfer it by its processes to other cells either in the spinosum or basal layer. Okay, it has long processes to transfer melanin directly without making a storage. Again, the melanocytes lighter between the basal cells, but here we have keratinocytes with a cap over the nucleus. شايفين the brown cap هاد like umbrella over the nucleus. This is the pigmentation اللي هو الميلانين. So these are pigmented epithelial cells. Okay? لا melanocytes حكينا بتصيرهاش pigmentation لأن directly synthesize and transfer the melanin. Again, this is the melanocytes with the keratinocytes, sorry, with the melanin making a cap over the nuclei. We need melanin to protect the nucleus from ultraviolet light, because these cells are undergo intense mitotic activity, so we need melanin to protect them against ultraviolet light. They are highly sensitive for ultraviolet light. Okay. Again, نشوف هون الكيراتو أو الكيراتينو هيالين granules inside أو in the stratum granulosum. شايفينهم هيهم. هذول هم الكيراتينو هيالين granules. اللي حكينا وظيفتهم to increase the molecular weight of keratin to make it more condensed. Here we have melanocytes. We have pigmented epithelial cells, the melanin making like a cap over the nucleus. Like an inside the spinous layer, or layer in his stratum spinosum, I have a lighter cell. This lighter cell is possible Langerhans cell. We are not sure till we see it under EM microscope. When you see it under EM microscope to identify the indented nucleus, or that it's going under engulfing, okay? يعني بتعمل macrophaging. ساعتها بنحكم عليها إنها Langerhans cell. But now it is possible Langerhans because it is lighter. Okay? It's very small in size. Here you have to identify the hair follicle, which is an invagination of the epidermis inside the dermis. And to make a tubule or a tube-like structure which is dilated here to make the hair bulb in this area, okay, and in contact with it opening in the hair follicle we have the sebaceous gland. The sebaceous gland, as you know, it is simple branched acinar or alveolar gland. هاي بالنسبة للستركتشر تاعها classification. Okay. إذا simple just one duct opening inside the hair follicle. Secretory part is a branched one. Shape of the secretory part is acinar or alveolar. طب هون under the sebaceous gland you can see this type of tissue going from the hair pulp inserted inside the dermis. This type of tissue is smooth muscle tissue. ماشي على pointer هذا. The smooth muscle tissue. وهاي المسل is called rectobili muscle. مسؤولة عن erection of the hair to become more vertical when it is contracted. Okay? Under the sebaceous gland attached to the hair pulp inserted inside the dermis. And we have here sweat gland رح نحكي عنهم بالتفصيل later. Again the hair, the longitudinal section, you have to know the layers of the hair just like this for the lab, the practical reasons. الثيوري مطلوب منكم أشياء ثانية كثير. بس for the lab, just you have to know the outer layer اللي هي dermal layer, layer of connective tissue اللي عليها البوينتر. And the inner layer is the epithelial layer أو dermal layer. Two layers. Dermal, the outer, connective tissue, والإبيديرمال. Okay? Here we can identify the hair pulp. Inside the hair pulp, I have a dermal papillae invagination. شايفينها؟ To give nutrients. شايف؟ لأنها بتكون highly vascularized, صح؟ بالتالي give nutrients for the hair. This dermal papillae. The tissue or the cells above the hair papillae, we call them hair root. انصار عندنا البلب والديرمال بابيلي والهير روت. These hair root, these cells are responsible or like a stem cell responsible for the formation of other cells. When they are differentiated, they give other cells in the hair. Okay? لا تفتح الباب. In this slide, we have a cross-section of the hair. Again, the outer layer is the connective tissue layer. Well, inner layer is the epidermal layer. Between them, I have a membrane. شايفينه؟ عليه البوينتر. طبعا دائما always we have between the connective tissue and the epidermis we have a basement membrane, صح؟ In the case of hair follicle, this membrane is called glossy membrane. واضح؟ إذا three parts here to know. The glossy membrane, the outer connective tissue dermal layer والinner اللي هي الإبيديرمال. Okay؟ Again, the sebaceous gland, حكينا, simple, branched, شايفين كيف branching of the secretory part, acinar or alveolar structure, opens inside the hair follicle. لا, secretory part نفسه هو branched, أكثر من واحد بيفتح علومين. Simple, لأن one duct opens inside the hair follicle. Okay. From the epithelium. Ah, شوف. بصير الطبقة الداخلية هي الإبديرمس والأوتر لاير هي الديرمس. هي invagination. تخيل أنت بدخل شغلة هيك لجوا. تعمل تيوب. آه. الديرما البابيلا ما هي بصير imagination لجوه من تحت بس منطقة البلد بس مش داخل زي صورة الوريتك يا رب مش للآخر واصل بس منطقة هاي اللي راح تكون covered بالهير اوكي ما راح تدخل لجوه لا الديرما البابيلا طيب هون عندنا sebaceous gland نشوف هون الإبيثيليوم اوكي طبعا السيلز هدول they are healthy cells Nuclei healthy, no damaging, okay. When we are going deep, more sebum, our secretion will be accumulated in the cells. Till and then the nuclei start to undergo damaging or shrinkage. Then the cell will be dive. Okay. And burst to give the secretions. Then هون راح يصير عندي damaging for the cell to give its secretion. And this is called, yes, holocran. Then the cell undergo damaging to give the secretion. It is holocran type of secretion. This is the sebaceous gland, okay? بالمقارنة this is a slide for the sweat gland. نعرف إنه according to the structure, the sweat gland is symbol, yes, called tubular. بالتالي عبارة عن tube أو tubular structure. And it is called, when we take a cross section, رح يظهر عنا these tubular structures. شايفينهم مول and alumen, shake. طيب, these dark structures هدول, these are the excretory ducts, اللي هي الدكت, اللي هي الاكسكريتوري بارت, okay? بتكون دبل لاير اوف كيوبويدال ايبيثيليوم forming the wall, inside في عندي the lumen. اذا هي stratified كيوبويدال ايبيثيليوم في حالة الاكسكريتوري دكت. Appears dark under the microscope. And the secretory part will appear lighter. Just one layer of simple cuboidal cells. Okay? Then simple cuboidal epithelium forming the secretory part. واضح؟ الفرق بيناتهم الداركر هي الدكتس والسكريتوري بارت is lighter. في حالة الدكت it is stratified cuboidal epithelium. في حالة secretory part just one layer so it is simple cuboidal epithelium. طيب هلا نشوف اللومن inside these secretory parts. They have a narrow lumen. Okay? Very narrow lumen. طلعوا عليها. نحكي عن secretory. احنا الدكت خلص. Okay? Secretory part has a very narrow lumen. For this kind of secretory sweat gland رح تكون الإكراني. Okay, في حالة كان lumen of the secretory part very narrow, this type of sweat gland is the eccrine أو في كتب تسميها mirocrine gland. في هاي الحالة secretion بيكون by only exocytosis without any damaging for the cell. ما بيروح منها ولا أي جزء الخلية. Okay, just simple exocytosis. طيب طلعوا على السكريتوري بارت هير. Surrounding the secretory part we have a flattened nuclei. شايفينهم؟ أو flattened layer of cells. This layer is the myoepithelial layer. It is responsible for the excretion of this secretory part. When they contract, they make the secretory part excretes its secretions. Okay? Inside the lumen. واضح اللي حكينا؟ Myo epithelial cells surrounding the secretory part. هم عبارة عن flattened cells. They contain alpha A actin. هذا موجود في السموث مصر. اطلعوا عنها كتبين. طيب, in comparison to the previous slide, we have here another secretory part in the sweat gland. But it differentiated from the previous one by, yes, a wide or large lumen. إذا بتفرق بإنها it has a large lumen. And then also I have these parts. شايفينهم هدول؟ هم عبارة عن parts of the cells undergoes shedding أو deattachment from the cell. Carrying the secretions with them. So this type of secretion is apocrine. جزء من السل بصيرها fragmentation أو إنها deattachment and go inside the lumen with the secretion. Okay? طبعا كمان في إشي بميزها. Look to the height of the cells. Here it is cuboidal cell. Okay? When you go there, the height increases. So we have different heights of cells. That means it is apocrine also. And an epicrine we can differentiate it by the shedding of the attachment, okay, by the wide lumen or large lumen, and by different heights of the cells forming the epithelium. واضح؟ طب الابوكراين وين موجودة؟ In all areas? No. In certain areas, زي الأكسلة مثلا. And it will be activated only after puberty. Okay? The secretion from this gland will contain proteins. مش زي الكراين. Okay? رح يكون فيها proteins. الباد سميل of the sweat refer to the bacterial actin. Yes. And not from the sweat. ما بيكون بسبب انه ما هو اصلا odorless sweat. Okay. But بسبب البكتيريا the bad smell will appear. Okay. Yes. Yes. بتطلع البعد smell. Okay. ولا هو اصلا odorless. في حد له سؤال؟ طبعا where it is open. Open. Where it opens? In the hair follicle. مش زي الإكراين. Directly on the surface of the skin. It will opens in the hair follicle like the sebaceous. يعني الأبوكراين and the sebaceous will opens inside the hair follicle. واضح؟ هذه السؤال؟ عشان